With the new generation of SMD magazines almost ready, I'm left with one big problem. They now feature a printed design, which looks awesome, but since I manufacture everything in-house, that also means I have to print on every single one of them on both sides. How do people actually print on products? In factories, it's often done with pad or screen printing, but that means dealing with messy inks, and I wasn't up for that. But Stefan recently got a Eufy Make UV printer. It's basically a traditional inkjet with cartridges, but UV cured. Think of it like a normal color printer for paper, except this one can print on almost anything. At first, I dismissed it. The printing is slow and the overall experience isn't really made for any kind of automation. It seemed way too tedious for thousands of magazines. But then I thought, what if we could make it work? Well, I turned this printer into a one-click printing solution that just works. At the core is a compact two-button unit wirelessly connected to a custom desktop app which is running Eufy Make Studio in a virtual machine, fully autonomously and unattended. 8 RGB LEDs built into the buttons give instant feedback at a glance, pulsing green when it's ready for the next job and turning red if something needs my attention. To speed things up, I designed a 3D printed jig that holds 16 magazines at once, one half upside down, the other right side up. After the first pass, I can simply flip them over to print the second side. With this, I can finish 2 full sets of magazines with almost no effort. And to make it truly hands-free, a small servo presses the start button at just the right moment, turning the whole process into a fully automatic printing workflow. But before going through all of this, I first tried another approach. I came across this small conveyor belt printer with an inkjet cartridge mounted on top. That is normally used to print barcodes or expiration dates onto products. It came with a small conveyor and would be much better to automate. However, even after experimenting with different inks, cartridges and settings, I couldn't even get close to any satisfying result. The ink is too thin and the capillary action of the 3D printed layer lines instantly draws away most of the ink. This produces a rather interesting but still unwanted appearance. We treated the surfaces before printing and even preheated the parts so they would dry faster. Things improved a tiny bit, but it was just unsatisfying still, which ultimately led me to go back to the Eufy Make. To make things easier, I 3D printed a jig which holds up to 16 magazines. The jig itself is already an improvement, as manually positioning the magazines on the tray is just painful. I do like the print results and build quality of the Eufy Make. The software, however, is lacking behind a bit. I mean, it's somewhat expected since the printer isn't even released yet, so a work-in-progress software is kind of expected. But anyways, let's jump into Eufy Make and see how it actually works. We start by taking a snapshot of the tray. This gives us a visual aid to correctly place our design before printing. Now I can drag and drop my print design onto the canvas, place it at the right location using the scan from before, and hit print. It takes a few minutes until the printer is ready. Then we have to walk over there and press the physical start button to actually start the print. So far, so good. But scanning the tray and placing the design visually isn't really precise. Fortunately, there was a software update while filming this video that fixed the zero-point alignment feature. This way we don't use a snapshot for reference, but absolute values for X and Y. There is a zero-point on the tray that's being used for calibration and to align our workpiece. This method is way better for repeatability and is exactly what I wanted to achieve with my jig. Printing takes roughly 7 to 8 minutes until it's finished. I then have to flip all the magazines for the second pass and hit print again. As you can see, printing is kind of a tedious process. So let's fix that first. I kind of like the idea of having a physical button to start a print. I mean, I'll stand right here after filling up the jigs anyways, so why not just have a button up here to kick off a print job? I really love how the buttons turned out, but in order to finish them, we still need some electronics. I already designed the PCB outline in Fusion 360 and finished the layout in KiCad. For this project, I chose to go with an RP2040 stamp and a new official wireless module. Besides a port for the servo and some USB input protection, we have two Cherry keyboard switches and a bunch of LEDs for the buttons. And that's pretty much it. The PCBs and stencils just came in, and while unboxing and applying some solder paste, this is the perfect opportunity to talk about today's sponsor. JLCPCB provides easy, affordable, and reliable PCB and PCBA solutions. In fact, I'm working with JLCPCB for a long time now. All the pixel pump mainboards come from JLCPCB, and the quality was always great. Ordering PCBs is super easy. Simply drag and drop your exported Gerbers, receive an instant quote, and place your order within minutes. Their large-scale production allows them to bring the cost for 1-to-8-layer PCBs down to just $2. Plus, it ensures really fast PCB turnaround times of just 24 hours. In fact, you can even track every manufacturing step in real time, which I end up doing all the time and think is pretty cool. So don't miss JLCPCB's 6-layer PCB special. Get $30 off with a coupon and enjoy top quality 6-layer PCBs. Plus a free 2-micron ENIC finish and no engineering fees for VIA and PAD. Check out the video description for more. We're now ready for assembly. First step, I've already pulled up the bill of materials, so I know exactly where each part goes. And since I always try to reuse parts from past projects, I could grab almost everything right from my stash. The PCB looks awesome, and even though I have written some MicroPython code to test if it works, it would make more sense to look at how we can remotely operate the desktop software before continuing here. Unfortunately, there is no API or any other way to interact with the printer than through the Eufy Make Studio. But I still want this stuff being hidden away in some black box that just accepts a print now command and does all the stuff behind the scenes. But how do we actually do that? Well, let's try an old trick. In UI testing, we use frameworks and libraries to simulate mouse clicks and keyboard button presses, and that's exactly what we'll be using here. The Eufy Make Studio is an Electron app, meaning it's basically a website wrapped in a native app, and therefore we cannot use the Windows or macOS APIs to directly interact with the UI elements. Instead, we have to manually perform mouse clicks on certain screen coordinates. So let's create a new Python project using UV and fire up VS Code. Now I want to use a package called PyAutoGUI. That is a neat little toolkit to simulate mouse clicks and keyboard button presses. It also includes functions to search for images on the screen using OpenCV's templating. And that's really cool for us to retrieve state. For example, I added a screenshot of the print button. I can now ask PyAutoGUI to scan the entire screen for this button. Once found, I get the location on screen, which I can then use to perform a click. Another example is making sure the printer is in the right state. I have a screenshot of the idle state. If we are able to locate that image on the machine tab, I know the printer is ready for a task. I decided to abstract away logic by dividing all tasks into workflows, which makes it easier to change or fix things later on. I mean, as soon as they update the UI of the Eufy Make Studio, things are likely gonna fall apart. But for now, this is pretty much the only way to get this fully automated. With the workflows being done, I can now call them sequentially in main.py. First, we'll make sure the Eufy Make Studio is in the foreground. Otherwise, the image search will obviously fail. Then we reset and check the UI. Next, we'll check if the printer is online and then check if it's idle. The next and final step is printing. In here, we locate and click the print button and then wait for the printer being ready. This is where the chime occurs and where we have to physically press the start button again on the printer itself. Our desktop software is now ready to run the Eufy Make Studio completely on its own. I have set up a virtual machine on my shipping computer and deployed the Python project there, so my Mac stays free for other work. To connect everything, the script includes MQTT support and automatically launches a broker called Mosquito. A broker is basically a server that passes those MQTT messages between devices. In our case, between the button box and the shipping computer running Eufy Make Studio. I can now send print commands over Wi-Fi and get live status updates for the button LEDs. Perfect, so let's finish the button box and see all of that in action. I really love MicroPython for projects like this. One of the tools in its ecosystem is mpremote, which makes working with connected devices super convenient. I've set up a few shortcuts to speed things up. For example, mpremote debug maps my current working directory directly to the controller, so I can run code instantly without ever copying anything over. And once everything's ready, a single deploy command transfers all the files to the device so it can run on its own. If I need a clean state, mpremote clear wipes everything and gets me right back to development. For this box, I went with a simple main loop that calls a tick function on all subcomponents. This non-blocking approach makes it easy to do things like smoothly transitioning between colors or debouncing button inputs. On top of that, I added a basic state machine that reacts to MQTT status updates from the desktop software. It's a clean and flexible setup for a MicroPython project and pretty much the same approach I had for the pixel pump. All of my shortcuts, including the entire project source code, are on GitHub. You'll find the link in the description if you want to go deeper. Being able to be in a workshop like this really means a lot to me. I can finally work on all the projects I've been dreaming about for years. And sharing the journey with you makes it even cooler. So,
it's a lot.
Prince,
das sieht jetzt aus.